Mimi niko na imani Kenya ita change. Kitu inafaa tujiulize mimi na wewe ni how will it change? Ni nini wewe utafanya na ni nini mimi nitafanya? Sio next week, sio next month, but saa hii, leo na kesho, to make sure that Kenya changes. Ndio maana lazima wewe as a Kenyan uparticipate kwa hiyo change. Because wewe usipokuwa, nani atakuwa? Lazima ifike point sisi wa Kenya tujiulize, if not me, then who? Mimi nilianza na kurekod TikTok video. Ikaenda viral, ikakuwa 1 million views. Nikarealize nimekuwa popular and famous. Sikutumia popularity na fame kujitajirisha ama kujibenefit. Nimeitumia kucreate platform ili youth wanitumie kama voice. In short, mimi ni voice yako. I just say publicly what you say in private. Mimi ni mfanyi kazi wako. Kazi yangu ni kuvoice out chenye iko kwa roho yako. And let me tell you, words are powerful. The earth, hii tuko, it was created by the word of God. He said and it happened. This conversation, hii kuongea tunaongea, it looks like small things. But it is the small things that make up big things. A friend of mine told me, if we connect a spider web with another spider web with another spider web, we can tie up a lion. But we must come together. Ukweli ni kwamba Kenya imeibiwa, tena sana. Kwanza wacha hizi zenye na waonyesha ati Ringo Stadium walitenga hii pesa, Katua, KN, Nguni Road walitenga hii pesa, ikaibiwa. That is a drop in the ocean. Pesa mingi yenye imeibiwa Kenya imeibiwa the revenue side. Revenue means mali gava ina collect do. Unajua mimi na waonyesha ngazile za expenditure. Venye gava ili spend do wakaiba. Maybe wakaweka mradi, kumbe ilikuwa mradi fake, hawakuwahi anza wakaiba do, ama wakaanza ikafika katikati wakaiba do yote wakashindwa kuendelea, ama wakaimaliza lakini wakaiba mali ya umma. Hiyo ndio mimi waonyesha sana juu ndio mtaelewa rahisi. Kuna ingine yenye ni bigger, yenye ndio pesa mingi mahali inapotea, ambayo ni revenue collection. Niwapee example moja. Leo nilikuwa naongea na senator wa Busia, nikamuuliza, "Hey boss, ni nini inaendelea Busia lakini?" Akaniambia, "Unajua kitu nafuu ujue, wakati Busia ilikuwa county council, wakati kuwa na makansela, ilikuwa ina collect up to 700-800 million. KRA ilikuwa ina collect 800 million. Lakini after devolution imekuja county imekam, sasa ni Busia county government. Revenue collection ilishuka bana, ina collect 100 million. How? Yet Busia imegrow, investment imegrow, taxes imegrow. Ni juu magavana wanaregister ma bank account, alafu hii revenue collection platform, pesa inaenda kwa account, tao yaendi kwa account ya serikali. Sasa, hiyo ni Busia. It happens in all the 47 counties. The worst mali pesa inaibwa kabisa ni Nairobi. Of course, because it's a capital city, it collects more money, so you can steal more money. Twende kwa governor, national government. Hawa kina William Ruto, hawa na kina Uhuru. Do you know what? These people treat Kenya as a prison. Where we are the prisoners, and Uhuru, Raila, Ruto, and those other people, they're the prison wardens. So they can fight on who will be the chief warden of the prison. They can always fight on that. One will say, mimi mkinifanya prison warden, chief prison warden, I'll allow you more time on the sun, mtaota jua, ntafumigate room zenu chawa zisi wakule, mtawangezea chakula, ikuwe mkuwe na ration kubwa. But what the Gen Z tried to do was to break the jail. And that is why the jail wardens united. The jail wardens can fight on who will be the chief warden, but they can never fight on whether the jail should exist. Because the jail is what benefits them. The jail has to continue existing for them to continue being wardens. So mlijaribu ku jailbreak, mlijaribu ku help a jailer to emancipate the population from the institution. That's why uliona waki unite, because sasa umewathreaten. Kumbuka tunaibiwa na kila mtu. Gava plus opposition. So kuna mtu naeza trust out of all those people. They are all thieves and plunderers. Mina shindonga, why does William Ruto still steal yet yeye ni president? Because una expect mtu akisha kuwa president afai kuwa mwizi. But nikakuja kuelewa mission ya watu. Mission ya watu ni waipe pesa ya Kenya, waipeleke abroad, waistore in dollars, wa make Kenya very poor, ndio warudishe ile do wanunue kila kitu, wa own the means of production na wa own economy. They own all the banks, they own all the ports, they own all the airports, they own all the railway lines, so that tukwe slaves in our own country, tuwawakie wawo kwe kama kingdom, kama empire, ndio wakuenge sasa hakuna aja elections. They hand it over to their sons to their sons, evil. That's their mission. Kitu imefanya wakashindwa kuiachieve ni juu ya mimi na wewe. Sasa kitu nafuu ujue, wewe mwenye unanisikiza hapo on social media, on Facebook, on TikTok, on Twitter. Sisi wenye tuko upstairs, tuko fiti, tushafunguka macho, tunajua mali Kenya inaelekea na tunajaribu kuisave. We are the minority. Majority of Kenyans hawaelewi nini inaendelea. Na majority of the Kenyans ndio wana vote. Kumbuka, system yetu ni democracy. Democracy ni ruled by majority. Na majority of Kenyans wako kwa village and informal settlements. Huko ndio, that's why after Gen Z protests, William Ruto didn't hold a rally in Nairobi. Alienda village. Because that's where he knows there are people he can lie to. How are we changing the game? Tusha change game because first, youth wame unrespect yao. Kitu ya pili tume change conversation ya siyasa. Kitu ya tatu, hii kitu ya tribeless, it's going very far. Because even watu wanatoka kwa tribe ya president, the Kalenjin Nation, wame realize wanaumia sana Ruto akiwa president, hadi wanajiuliza, is it of any benefit mtu wao kuwa kwa serikali? So hii kitu ya mtu wetu tunaimaliza. Because hata wao wameumia. So don't hate on them. Ukipatata wale wachache wenye wanamsupport, don't abuse them. Win them over with love. It's easier to win someone over than to fight them. Sawa sawa. So now, let's go back. How we are changing the game plan. Kitu ya kwanza, ya tunafaa kuchange, ni commercialization of our politics. Wanasiasa wali create system yenye siasa ni about pesa. Then wanaiba pesa ya kutosha. So you make the politics to be about the money, then you steal the highest amount of money so that now you are the only one who can win elections. Unaona hiyo style yenye mama mboga wananitumianga 10 bob. Unajua mi utumiwa hadi na watu wa boda 100 bob. Natumiwa na watu wa diaspora 1,000. Na nime create trust na Kenyans. Wachana na hao watu wanasema, oh ni conman anajaribu kujitajirisha. Nilikuwa tajiri kabla nianze siasa, God had already given me wealth at a young age. Hiyo ni mambo tu ya upuzi. The main point ni, huu mama mboga ndiye ajitolea ato hiyo 20 bob. Akutumie, juu ana believe in what you do. That is something bana. Hiyo ni kitu jaifanyika Kenya. Kenya inajulikananga kwamba wanasiasa ndo wanapea watu pesa. Wanapelekea vijanado, watu wa bodaboda pesa, wanawanunua, wanawapea pombe, ndio wanawakampenia na wanawavotia. Lakini mimi nimechange the other way round. Wananchi sasa wanapea wanasiasa pesa. Watu wamekuwa kinichangia, walinichangia nikabai gari, wakanichangia nikanunua sound system, nikamount juu hiyo gari, na niliwaambia hiyo gari ni yenu. Sikunawacha hii story, napea mtu mwingine mwenye.
So the speech you have just seen there by Murara Kebaso is one of the greatest speech I've ever heard, and that's why I decided to post it on this platform so that the message can spread out there. It's sad, which I have hope, and indeed we Kenyans have hope on a better future because this is our home. And the question is, what will we do so that we can change our home? Because we have no other Kenya than this one. We, the youth, we have rose, we have woken up, and we are doing other better things than what people ever thought we could do. That's the reality. So, Murara just came out with this video, which has really gotten a lot of traction online, and it has really got a lot of engagement on social media platform that many Kenyans are now saying that this is the greatest speech I have ever heard from somebody for the longest time. So, Murara just came out to say that the voice or the videos which he's doing is a result of the Kenyans, because he is just a voice, he's just a vessel for the Kenyans, because wherever these Kenyans are saying in private, is only the difference is that he only goes out in public and tries to talk about this subject, which most Kenyans are not talking about, and that's the reality. So he said we must come together because small things make big things. The small cobweb, if you add small cobwebs and other cobwebs, they will tie a lion, and that's what Morara quoted, and I'm quoting from him. So he said that the words are very powerful because the word, even God created the world with words, and that's the reality which we must talk about right now. So that's what's going on going in Kenya. And even from that, Morara Kebaso exposed something which I really need to talk about this evening, and that is about revenue collection. He went ahead to say that these monies we see that he's talking about are these stadiums, Ruringu Stadium or Wode Stadium. These are just small things. These are just small. These are a way which a lot of money is being stolen, and not many Kenyans talk about it. There's a lot of way which a lot of money is going down the drain, and not everybody is really talking about it, and that's the reality. So in what way are we going to curb it? Because he went ahead to say, example, that he was with Omkia Omtata, and when they talked about revenue collection in Busia County, he said that Busia County used to collect 800 million in revenues per year to KRA. That was before devolution, and that time there was no much revenue collection because right now taxes have increased and there is supposed to be higher revenue collection. And he said that the thing which is happening right now is that these governors are opening a lot of proxy companies and tax bank accounts, which now the revenue passes, and that's how revenue is being stolen. We have seen in Machakos where the county has more than 300 bank accounts. Just imagine, 300 bank accounts for what? That means it's an avenue for channeling money out of the county. So he said that they are a very big theft, and a lot of measures need to be taken. For example, that Busia right now is collecting very little money, as opposed to what was happening before devolution, and that raises a lot of questions. You also say that the counties which is very big in theft of revenue is Nairobi County, because there is a lot of revenue collection and Nairobi is the capital city. Apart from that, another shocking thing which he exposed is that right now Kenya is being treated as a prison, and the politicians are prison warriors. So when the Gen Z rose up and decided to fight for their rights, it's like the wardeners felt that the prisoners want to escape, and that's why they united, and that's why we saw Raila and Ruto come together, because they felt threatened. They felt that these people have woken up and they are going to beat us, or they are going to remove us, because these prisoners are going to get their freedom. You said that, you just gave an example of how a prisoner or a prison warden could just come out and campaign by telling the prisoners that if you give me a chance, I will give you more food, I will give you more time outside, and I give you better environments. That's basically what politicians are doing. So they have failed to achieve something they want, or a society which they want to create, that where they are only the ones who are rich, and the leadership, they pass it through their own generation, and that's what they wanted. But it seems not to, it won't happen anytime soon, because Kenyans are not stupid, or Kenyans won't accept that. So that's have failed, because even now the politicians are trying to commercialize politics, and if they commercialize politics, that's the role of Gen Z to destroy that commercialization of politics, because the politician will steal a lot of money, then will come back with those money so that he can win in election. Right now, for example, in like Nairobi, to be an MP, you might end up spending even 100 million in campaigns, and that you might not even end up winning, because you have seen most of these people who lose politics, they might end up even getting depression, because they spend a lot of money and they still lose elections. So Kenyans are awake, Kenyans are very well organized, and they have the best civic education. So if Kenyans, we rise up and fight this war we are fighting, then we will be blessed, and God won't let us down. So we must really wake up and fight governance, bad governance, which is ongoing. We must wake up and chase away this corruption, which is really getting deeper and deeper, especially in the counties right now. We have seen what is happening in Machakos. You have heard of politicians being arrested abroad with millions of money. We have seen CSS traveling with stashes of money abroad. That's what's happening in Kenya right now. And we really hope that we wake up and God bless the nation of Kenya. Thank you so much. Stay tuned for the next video.